Good afternoon, dear students. Very good afternoon, and welcome to the Byju's exam prep. I welcome to this beautiful session, top 11 questions discussion. Come on, dear students, join the session. This is the production engineering part 2. We are going to discuss the good questions. Chalo, jaldi se join kar lo, dear students. Very welcome once again to the Byju's exam prep. And after yes, long time we are meeting for the subject production engineering. Yes, the first part is already get conducted by Dheeraj sir, that is a casting, welding, material science. Okay, rest of the production engineering like metal forming, metal cutting, metrology, the CIMS, all things, okay, are here, are included in this particular session. We are going to solve a very good questions. Shubham, welcome Shubham, very good afternoon. Chalo, jaldi se aajao, show me some presence there in the chat box, whether I am audible and visible to you nicely. Come on, yes, Rupali, good afternoon. Shubham, good afternoon. I'm audible and visible, guys. Very fast. There are so many students live, definitely. Come on. And yes, some good questions we are going to solve. So be there till last and share this session amongst your friends so that they can also join, dear students. Come on, very fast. Chalo, jaldi se bata do, I'm audible and visible to you perfectly. So of course, dear students, this is GATE Super 11 Mechanical Engineering Production Part 2. Okay, we are going to have today. So like the session, okay, share the session, and dear students, don't forget to subscribe our channel, right? So of course, dear students, this is the GATE Super 11 15 days revision series is actually going on. And today, the Production Engineering Part 2, we are going to solve a very good questions on these particular topics. Okay, part 2. Chalo, this is about me. I am Omkar, having more than 10 years of experience for teaching GATE and ESE. Till now I have mentored more than 10,000 number of students. My area of expertise are production and industrial engineering, fluid mechanics, mechatronics and robotics as well, maintenance engineering as well. Okay, so let us start. If everything is perfectly all right, then we can just go ahead. Okay, clear hai, any doubt? So be ready with the calculators, okay, because we are going to solve some good questions definitely. Loga Vignesh, welcome. Am I audible and visible, Loga? Come on, very fast, just. Ellen, yes, definitely, it is an English channel. We are going to discuss in the English only. Ellen, welcome, Ellen. And don't forget that again, after this session, we are going to conduct one more session on our Hindi channel, that is Complete Production Engineering, just after, day after tomorrow at 5 p.m. Okay, on our Hindi YouTube channel, I am coming live with the Complete Production Engineering. Thank you, Rupali. Thank you so much. So are you ready, guys? Are you ready? Hit the like button and subscribe our channel. And Sushil, very welcome, dear. Chalo, let me know very fast who are there in the chat box. Okay, chalo, have some movement in the chat box. So definitely the class is live. Okay, and I can go ahead. Chalo. So let us take the very first question in front of you. Tell me the correct answer. Chat box should be moving with your actually reply for the question. Okay, you have to answer in the chat box. In the measurement of the surface roughness, the heights of the successive peaks and the valleys overhead atom, the peaks and valleys, actually the heights are obtained, okay, on the specified length L, okay, are given in the following table. The theoretical surface roughness of the surface is, so whenever from the datum we are actually calculating the maximum surface roughness, okay, that is the theoretical surface roughness, you know which is the value there, Sushil, whether it is RA, RZ or RT, that is which value you simply take over a datum. You want to write here the surface roughness, theoretical surface roughness is simply given by the RT value, that is going to be the H maximum minus H minimum from your profile. Okay, so here it is from the datum. Suppose this is H1, this is valley H2, this is peak H3, this is valley H4, this is peak H5 like that, H6, this is H7. So definitely looking to this profile, what you want? Do you want maximum peak here? Suppose H3 is the maximum peak and here minimum valley is where? So minimum of this valley, it is H4. So the difference between this, you can simply write the maximum surface roughness or simply the theoretical surface roughness. Okay, so here simply not profile is given, but the peaks and valleys values are given in the micron. So you have to take the maximum from the peak and minimum from the valley if from one datum we are having the profile. So here from the one datum only, over a datum line only, they have given the profile. So you have to get here maximum of the peak how much. So if you select here 55, 74, 46, 87, so it is going to be the 87 micron. Okay, and what is the minimum of the valley? So see, minimum of the valley here H4, so here which is the minimum? 35 micron. Okay, so definitely dear students, now we can simply get the difference between these two, that is 87, okay, 87 minus, that is RT, which is nothing but the maximum or theoretical surface roughness. Okay, it is going to be the difference between this 87 minus 35. How much it is? How much it is? Chalo jaldi se bata da, how much it is? How much is the surface roughness value? 87 minus 52. Come on, come on. Show me the answer in the chat box. 87 minus 35. It is going to be 52 microns. Okay, this is the value. This is the value. Very good, Ishan. Ishan, very good, Ishan. Welcome, Ishan. So 52. Yes, C Chennai is the correct answer. Come on, come on. Loga, yes, correct, absolutely correct. C Chennai is the correct answer. Come on, share the session, like the session, and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Please, please, please. Yes, fantastic, guys. It is 52 micron. Yes, Shubham Vittalkar, very good, very good. Suppose I am having the profile, okay, as an profile is getting divided by the equal, in the equal areas, okay. Like this, whatever the region is above and whatever the region below this particular this line, okay. In this case, what will be the RT value? So we can have the maximum and peak and the deepest valley. If you just go on summing these two, maximum peak and the deepest valley, dear students, okay. In this case, RT value, that is RT value, is going to be when there is a line which is equally dividing the profile in the two regions like peaks and valleys, right? So in that case, you take the maximum peak and the deepest valley, that will be your RT value, that the difference in that. So simply you can just go on adding. So that will be the maximum roughness, theoretical surface roughness you can obtain in this RT form. Okay, RA value, you know, dear students, RA is nothing but the center line average. So number of peaks plus number of valleys divided by the length over which you are defining, or sorry, the numbers, how many numbers that you have counted there. Okay, in terms of area also you can do, that is summation of the areas in the peaks and valleys divided by the length. Okay, you can do like that, yes or no? And RZ value, you just take the 5 peaks plus 5 valleys divided by 10, it is going to be your RZ value. So this is the way you can find out RA value, RT value and RZ value, you know very well. I hope the surface roughness things are clear here from the metrology. I hope it is clear. I hope it is clear. If it is clear, if I say, let us go for the next question. Next question, what is that? Okay, yes, it is from the CNC machine. Okay, it is from this sim chapter. The XY table of the CNC drilling machine has to move from point, say, 1, 1, 2, 6, 3. Okay, where the given coordinate dimensions are in millimeter. If axis can move at the velocity is given dear 12 millimeter per second. Okay, no issue. And the basic length unit is given 0.00254, okay, millimeter again. Okay, then the travel time in second, and the resolution in millimeter is how much? Okay, suppose I am having this table at point A here, which is having the coordinates 1, 1, and I have to move this table from A to B, where the coordinates going to be 6, 3. So you just see on in the xy plane, what is the movement in the x direction? You will be say x direction distance traveled, it will be 6 minus 1, that is say 5 millimeter. And in y direction, if I say the distance traveled is 3 minus 1, it is going to be 2 millimeter. You know, dear students, the velocity is nothing but the distance divided by time. Okay, so if I just calculate here time taken along this x axis and time taken along the y axis, calculate the time taken along x axis. So time to move this particular axis, time taken along the x axis. Chalo batao jaldi se, how much is that? Time taken along x axis. You know, dear students, the distance. So distance divided by velocity, that is 6 minus 1, 5 divided by velocity is 12 mm per second. Okay, so it will be time taken along the x-axis, it will be 0.41 second. Okay, and time taken along y-axis. So how much is the displacement along y-axis? It is going to be 2 millimeters. So 2 divided by 12. Okay, it is going to be say 0.166 second. And you know that whenever you are having such a times, okay, along x and y-axis, whichever the maximum time required, okay, you have to wait until that, yes or no? That will be the total time to actually reach from point A to point B. So whichever the maximum here, this is the 0.41. So definitely we require here 0.41 seconds, okay, in this question. Very simple, very simple. So if, see what they are asking, then the time, travel time they are asking. So which travel time you are going to get here? Which is the maximum one? That will be our travel time. Even though y-axis required only 0.16, but this x-axis required 0.41 second. So that will be the travel time. And you know the resolution is nothing but what? For which is the smallest distance that can, that axis can move for the one pulse, the value of one pulse, which is known as the resolution also. That is also known as the basic length unit. Basic length unit hi kya hoti hai bhaiya? The resolution of that machine tool. Yes, Jitendra Kumar, very, very good afternoon. So resolution and BLU are same only, therefore how much resolution is here? That is nothing but the amount of BLU, which is 0.0254 millimeter. So resolution will be how much? And resolution, nothing but, dear student, that is the smallest distance traveled by the axis for the value of one pulse, that is the BLU, which is going to be 0.00254 millimeter. Tell me the correct answer now. Therefore answer will be how much? Time will be 0.41 second and resolution will be 0.00254 mm. So tell me what is the correct answer. Good afternoon, Jitendra. So this is the second question. Second question we have solved. So what is the answer? So 0.41 definitely out of this B and C. Yes, dear students, B Bombay. B Bombay is the very correct answer. Isn't it okay? Yes or no? I hope this is the question on your computer integrated manufacturing system, BLU. Many times they are asked the question on the BLU. Please remember the how to calculate basic length unit. Okay, so basic length unit can be calculated as number of starts on your lead screw multiply by the pitch of the lead screw. Pitch of the lead screw. If the ratio, gear ratio is there between the motor and the lead screw, the coupling is there, the speed reduction is there, you can have the gear ratio divided by your number of pulses, okay, or steps per revolution. Okay, that is nothing but the standardized formula for the BLU. Why not magnitude of distance? Okay, so are you getting my point here? So it is not given here, so you can directly calculate. Okay, if it is given, it is okay. ये ओके राहुल, ओके राहुल। ओके कहां से आते हैं ऐसे लोग, राइट? सो बीएलयू, आई होप यू विल कैलकुलेट द बीएलयू। सो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला, प्लीज गो थ्रू दैट। टेक द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, टेक द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सॉल्व दिस। चलो, माइल स्टील इज मशीन्ड बाय अ स्लैब मिलिंग कटर ऑफ 75 mm डायमीटर। द मिलिंग कटर विद द सफिशियंट विड्थ इज यूज टू रिमूव 5 mm थिक मटेरियल फ्रॉम 200 mm लॉन्ग पार्ट इन अ सिंगल पास। द टेबल फीड रेट इज 18 mm पर मिनिट। इफ द अप्रोच एट द ओवर ट्रेवल ऑफ द कटर इज नेग्लेक्टेड, देन ऑफकोर्स इट इज गोइंग टू बी द MSQ क्वेश्चन। सॉल्व इट एंड टेल मी द आंसर। चलो चलो सॉल्व करो, प्लीज हैव द कैलकुलेशन विद द कैलकुलेटर। यस, सो स्लैब मिलिंग ऑपरेशन इज देयर, ऑफकोर्स विद द स्लैब मिलिंग कटर दे आर डूइंग दिस ऑपरेशन। ओके, सो इन दिस केस यू नो द अप्रोच, कंपल्सरी अप्रोच यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट। यस सर, नो, कंपल्सरी अप्रोच यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट। हाउ विल कैलकुलेट दैट? दिस स्लैब इज गिवन विद द विड्थ, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द लेंथ इज हाउ मच? द लेंथ इज गोइंग टू बी 200 mm। यस सर, नो, यस, कम ऑन, कम ऑन। देन व्हाट इज द कंपल्सरी अप्रोच इन केस ऑफ दिस कटर? विच इज द कटर देयर? कटर इज स्लैब मिलिंग कटर। ओके, सो कंपल्सरी अप्रोच फॉर दिस स्लैब मिलिंग कटर AP1 इज व्हाट? रूट ओवर डी इन टू ब्रैकेट डी माइनस स्मॉल डी। सो स्मॉल डी इज व्हाट? डेप्थ ऑफ कट इज हाउ मच हियर फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर स्लैब और स्लॉट? सो डायमीटर ऑफ द मिलिंग कटर इज कैपिटल डी इज गोइंग टू बी 75 mm। ओके, स्मॉल डेप्थ ऑफ कट और यू कैन से द डेप्थ ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर स्लॉट, सो 5 mm थिक मटेरियल वी आर गोइंग टू रिमूव। ओके, सो डी इज गोइंग टू बी 5 mm। अरे हाय ना, येस सुशील, अंडर रूट ऑफ दिस वैल्यूज स्मॉल डी इंटू ब्रैकेट कैपिटल डी माइनस स्मॉल डी। टेल मी, सो वॉट इज द अप्रोच यू आर गेटिंग हियर? कटर डायमीटर इज 75 mm। जस्ट आई विल राइट हियर, AP1 इज गोइंग टू बी डी इज 5 mm, कैपिटल डी इज गोइंग टू बी 75 mm। कंपल्सरी अप्रोच कैलकुलेट वेन यू आर हैविंग दिस स्लैब मिलिंग कटर। ओके, इट इज गोइंग टू बी 5 × 75 - 5, इट इज हाउ मच? इफ यू कैलकुलेट इट, इट इज गोइंग टू बी हाउ मच? How much it is? 18.70 mm I am getting. 18.70. Please check it out. Check it out. 18.70. Yes, yes, yes. Compulsory approach I am getting here. A is the correct option. 18.70. 18.70. Very good. Very good. Very good. 18.70. Then what? Of course, here the length is given, dear students. How much length of this particular workpiece? Very good, Ishan, very good. So length is how much? 200 mm. Now total length will be how much? L total is nothing but the compulsory approach AP1 plus length. How much length of the workpiece is there for this slot? Okay, it is going to be 200 plus approach you have calculated 18.70. The L total will be 218.70 mm. Now you know very nicely how to calculate the machining time for this. That is the total length, L total, divided by you are having the feed F3, which is in mm per minute. How much is the feed given in mm per minute? It is already given. The feed rate is given, that is table feed is given, 18 mm per minute. F3 value is already given. So 218.70 divided by F3 is how much? 18. Tell me, what will be the time? How much is the time required to do this milling operation, slab milling operation? How much it is? Kitna aa raha hai dekho? I am getting here 12.15 minutes. Please check it out whether you are getting this much. Yes, please do the calculation. Yes. Okay. Very good, very good. And if it is a face milling operation, dear students, face milling, very fast. If it is a face milling operation with face milling cutter, FMC, then you know the compulsory approach will be how much? It is half into bracket D minus root over this D square minus W square, where W is the width or width of your workpiece, like this. So this is the width, okay. And this is, of course, milling cutter is here. Face milling operation. Haina. Isn't it? So face milling, this is the compulsory approach. And for the slab milling with the slab milling cutter, your approach, compulsory approach is this. Okay. So next question. Yes, 12.15 is the correct answer. 12.15 is the correct answer. Come on, next question on the powder metallurgy. Okay, the powder metallurgy component is kept in the oil bath which penetrates the voids by capillary action. In which of the following secondary operation the above mechanism will take place? Yes. So, infiltration, basically it is the operation in the powder metallurgy where the powder metallurgy components are dipped in the low melting point temperature alloys or liquids, okay, such as that, dear students, the oils or that liquid is going to flow into the voids by the capillary action, and when the liquid is going to reach there in the particular voids, okay, the voids are going to decrease and the strength of the component is going to increase. So this is nothing but the infiltration. This is nothing but the infiltration. Okay, when you talk about the sintering, so it is under the controlled atmosphere, the temperature just below the melting point temperature of the material, the green compact is going to heat it. Okay, that is known as the sintering. Repressing is one of the again operation where the similar kind of operation, that is the repressing mein kya hota hai? The powder metallurgical components are subjected to the some pressure so that the strength of this component is goes on increasing and the density also goes on increasing. Okay, so repressing again performed on the powder metallurgical components only. But in the impregnation, dear students, okay, it is similar to that of infiltration, but here the components are kept in the oil bath. Okay, in an oil bath. So this is a very important thing. So infiltration, they are dipped into the particular alloys with the low melting temperature alloy liquids, okay, right? And here in the impregnation, they are put into the oil baths. That is a very important difference between the infiltration and the impregnation. So here B, Bombay is the correct answer. I told you all the meanings, okay, for option A, option C and option D. Okay, C, D definitely are different than this AB, okay, but here in the impregnation generally we are using these oil baths. Okay, so B, Bombay is the correct answer for question number 4. Okay, let us have the next question. Next question. A solid circular flat disc of stainless steel workpiece with the initial diameter of 300 mm and 50 mm thickness homogeneously pressed forged between the flat dies to final thickness. So original thickness given, it is 50 millimeter, very good. Final thickness they are saying that it is 25 millimeter, very good. Original diameter is how much? 300 mm. Okay, you can very nicely calculate the d final by the volume constancy. Tell me, the d final is going to be this do root over ho divided by h final. That is 300 root over 50 divided by 2. Okay, mu is given. Of course, mu is the given, that is 0.25. And average flow stress is given here. It is 1000 megapascal. Are you getting my point? So here definitely they are asking the force in the forging operation at the end of the stroke. I told you many times, dear students, the force at the end of the stroke when the mu is given. Okay, you know how to get that force. This force at the end of the stroke is nothing but you can have the average flow stress or the yield strength of the material into final cross sectional area into the shape factor of that particular forging. So how to get the shape factor? Shape factor is equal to what? 1 plus 2 mu rf divided by 3 times hf. This is the shape factor. Yes or no? So just put the value here. 1 plus 2 into mu is how much? 0.25, no? Yes, 25 into final radius. I required here 3 times final thickness or height. It is 25 here. So tell me, what is the d final here? So d final how much here? 300 into root 25. Oh, 50 divided by 25. So root over 2. So 300 multiplied by root over 2, it is going to be 424.26 mm. Check it out. 424.26. So if it is final diameter, tell me the what is final radius. So directly can write here, final radius will be how much? 212.30. So tell me how much is the shape factor is coming. Shape factor, how much is the shape factor is coming? Whether it is 2.414. Yes, if it is there, please check it out. Check it out. It is a shape factor for this forging operation, 2.414. Now put the values. Flow stress is given to you. A final, that is final cross sectional area, you can calculate very nicely. That is AF is going to be pi by 4 DF square. DF already you have calculated, 424.26. Let us put the values. Therefore, force is going to be this 1000 average flow stress into pi by 4. Diameter kitna hai? 424.26 whole square into shape factor, how much? 2.414. How much it is? How much it is? How much it is? 2.414, that is going to be the shape factor, absolutely correct. So now I want the force. How much is the force at the end of the stroke? Force at the end of the stroke. How much? So I am getting here 341.29 mega Newton. Check it out. 341. Check it out. What they are asking? In mega Newton they are asking up to 2 decimals. So I am getting here 341.29. Check it out. Tell me the answer. Okay, that's fine. 341.29 up to 2 decimal. Yes, that is absolutely correct. Very good. Very good, Sushil, Ishan. Very good. Very good. Fantastic. 341.29. This is the forging force at the end of the stroke. I told you, dear students, whenever the mu is given there, they are asking at the end of the stroke. So this is the formula you have to use. Simply, many times you can directly get this formula like this. That is sigma y or sigma flow average into area, final cross section area into bracket 1 plus this 2 mu rf divided by 3 times h. This is the direct formula you can write. Okay, very good, very good, fantastic. Come on, dear students, take the next question and solve this question. HSS tool is used for turning operation. The tool life is 90 minutes. Okay, tool life T1 90 minutes. When the velocity cutting speed what? 50 meter per minute. Okay, very good. Then the tool life reduced to 9 minutes. So tool life T2 is going to be 9 minutes. When the speed is doubled. Okay, speed is doubled means V2 will be how much? If V1 is 50, then doubled means what? It is 100. Okay. Now, what the suitable speed in revolution per minute for the turning 300 mm diameter so that tool life is 30 minutes. So now they are asking T3 is 30 minutes. So what will be the V3? And from that V3 you can calculate N, that is RPM. Diameter is given 300 mm, वेरी गुड वेरी गुड. चलो यूज द टेलर्स टू लाइफ इक्वेशन, यूज द टेलर्स टू लाइफ इक्वेशन, वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन. चलो चलो बताओ, v1 t1 टू द पावर n इज इक्वल टू v2 t2 टू द पावर n इज इक्वल टू कॉन्स्टेंट. v1 कितना है, इट इज 50 इंटू t1 इज हाउ मच 90 टू द पावर n इज इक्वल टू v2 इज 100 इंटू दिस t2 9 टू द पावर n. इट इज गिवन ऑलरेडी, जस्ट गो एंड चेक हियर, सी हियर t1 t2 v1 v2 वैल्यूज आर देयर. जस्ट टेल अस एक्सपोनेंट यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट फर्स्ट, n विल बी हाउ मच दिस. Just I will, if I take here 90 by 9 to the power n is equal to say 100 by 50, so it is going to be 10 to the power n, it is going to be 2. So n ln of 10 is equal to ln of 2, therefore n will be how much, n will be how much, very good very good, it is going to be 0.3, very good, it is 0.3. Calculate the constant now very fast. If any value, any equation, if you put the value, say v1 kitna tha 50 into t1 90 to the power 0.3, it is going to be the constant. See how much it is, I am getting here 193.75, this is the constant. And now the same equation I can apply for the third condition, that is v3 t3 to the power n is equal to constant. They are saying just find out the V3 first, V3 is unknown, but T3 you know how much, T3 is now 30 minute to the power n is 0.3 is equal to constant is 193.75. Calculate the V3 value, that is the cutting speed when the cutting the tool life is 30 minutes. Okay, you are getting how much here, come on very fast, tell me how much you are getting here. Yes, C is the correct, 193.75, that is absolutely correct. 193.75, absolutely correct. What is the V3 value, that is the speed at the tool life of 30 minutes? Tell me very fast. It is going to be, I'm getting here 69.84 meter per minute I'm getting. Check it out whether it is correct. Very good. 69.84. If V3 is 69.84, you know that yes, your cutting speed is calculated as pi d n divided by 1000. So n is going to be 1000 VC divided by pi D. So here cutting speed is 69.84 I am getting. So 69.84 into 1000. And how much is the diameter? Pi times, they are saying when the diameter of that turning rod 300 mm, put the value here 300 mm. Okay, so we will get the RPM. Tell me how much RPM is there. The value of n they are asking from the cutting speed. Very easily you can calculate. Very easy. Tell me the answer. I am getting here the RPM around 74.10 revolution per minute. Check it out. 74.10. 71.10 are you getting? 71.10. Okay, D daily, I hope D should be the correct answer. Chalo, very fast, Rishi Gauli, yes, Rishi, Shubham, Sushil, Ishan, Shubham, 74, very good, D daily is the answer I am getting, D daily. Very good. 74.10. But near about D. Very good. So D Delhi is the correct answer. Very good. Take the next question. A cylindrical block of diameter DO and height HO is forged to the disc diameter DF and the HF. In open die forging, the ratio of magnitude of the true longitudinal strain to the true radial strain. There was a cylindrical block. It is getting forged in the open die forging when it was having the height H original, okay, and the original cross sectional area with the diameter say D original. It is forged in the, of course, disc, okay, of course diameter goes on increasing and the height goes on decreasing, that is of course volume constant is there, and this is the HF. okay, so there will be the reduction in the height and increase in the diameter. Okay, so longitudinal strain will be what? Along the height. So height is, of course, it is undergoing the compression, so compressive strain is going to be there. Are you getting my point? So I will write here the strain along the longitudinal direction, longitudinal, it will be what? That is change in height divided by original height. And here I will write the minus sign because it is a compressive, it is decreasing from say H final to H original, that is dH upon H. And that is what? Ln of dH by H, integral dH by H, it is what? Ln of H from the limits H final to the H original, it is minus sign. So if I put the limits ln of say HO minus this ln of HF, okay, it is going to be what? So minus, if I multiply with the minus sign inside the bracket, so it will be ln of HF minus ln of HO. So it will be how much? Simply it will be ln of this H, what you are getting, final divided by H original. This is the strain in the longitudinal direction. Okay, now also we know that, dear students, if I apply the volume constancy principle, you know volume is equal to what? Area into H. Of course it is constant, going to be constant in the all the metal forming process. Okay, so if I just differentiate it, that is ADH first term by UV rule, first term into ddx of second plus second term into ddx of first is equal to say constant derivative 0. So I will get here what? Since dH by H I will get here is equal to minus this dA by A. Yes or no? So same, already we obtained the longitudinal strain is how much? Longitudinal, how much we are obtained? By integrating this minus dH by H, okay, from H final to H original. Same way, I can also get this longitudinal strain in terms of the area. From area is going to increase, cross-sectional area is going to increase from A original to A final. It is plus because it is increased, dA by A. What is the area, cross-sectional area? It is pi r square or pi by 4 d square. Pi r square, r is the radius of the cylindrical part, r is the radius of the disc, you can say. So dA will be what? It is 2 pi r dr. Okay, and what is this change in the longitude, this longitudinal strain is what? Sigma epsilon L is equal to integral A original to A final. This dA is 2 pi r dr, here in this equation I am putting, divided by A is what? Pi r square or pi r square, capital R or just write a small r, no in issue. So this pi pi get cancelled out, r get cancelled out, so it will be dr by r. Are hai na? So it will be 2 times integral 2 times what? Dr upon r. Integral say A original to A final dr upon r. So area, this area can I write in terms of the radius? Of course, yes, I can write simply r original to r final, this integral dr upon r, which is in nothing but ln of r from r original to r final. It is 2 times. If I put the limits, it's simply 2 times ln of, I will get here r final divided by r original. If I put the limit, which is nothing but your longitudinal strain. And if I see here, that is ln of r final divided by r original, it is nothing but what? It is the strain in radial direction. This is the radial strain. So yes, in this suppose equation A, if I put here, this longitudinal strain is equal to 2 times, this is epsilon r, which is the strain in the radial direction. So tell me how much is the answer, what they are asking, what they are asking. So the ratio of the magnitude of the true longitudinal strain to the radial strain, if I take here, the ratio if I take here, therefore, epsilon L divided by epsilon r is going to be 2. So 2 is the correct answer. 2 is the correct answer here. 2 is the correct answer here. 2 is the correct answer. I hope you are getting this thing. Shubham, Rishi, 2 is the correct answer. 2 value. Simply 2. 2 times. So you are getting here longitudinal strain is equal to 2 times the radial true strain. Okay. So 2 is the answer. You have to write here 2 only. Very good, very good, very good. Let us take the next question. Yes, it is 2, absolutely correct. A tension test on a special drawing, deep drawing steel showed a 30% elongation in its length and 16% decrease in its width. The high resistance to thinning in the thickness direction, okay, the R for the steel is expected to. Basically, this question is related to the deep drawability, where you can just get the limiting drawing ratio. Limiting drawing ratio is the ratio of the blank size or the blank diameter you have to the punch diameter, that is capital DB divided by DP. Okay, this is the actually the ratio, the maximum ratio of the blank diameter divided by punch diameter. This is basically known as the limiting drawing ratio. Limiting drawing ratio. And in the many of the attempts, dear students, that are actually put here to how to represent this ratio, how to represent or correlate this ratio in terms of some mechanical properties of the sheet metal. So it is done, dear students, and it is observed that basically the failure of this particular sheet metal or this cup in the deep drawing operation, it is basically because of the huge amount of tensile stresses in the longitudinal direction. Okay, and based on that, dear students, we have obtained one ratio which is known as the R, which is known as the normal anisotropy of the sheet metal, which is also called as the strain ratio. Okay, this R is given as the simply the strain in the width direction divided by strain in the thickness. Okay, so this particularly again, dear students, modified equation, if you want to write here based upon the volume constancy, this R, which is normal anisotropy or the strain ratio of the sheet metal, is calculated as this R is equal to ln of this original width divided by final width of this particular cup divided by ln of into bracket this final width divided by original width into final length divided by original length. So this is the normal anisotropy. Okay, normal anisotropy. So here what is given dear? So tension test on a special deep drawing steel showed 30% elongation, that is change in length by original length. Elongation, you know, you can write very nicely, that is change in length, original length minus final length divided by original length, it is going to be 30%, that is 0.30. okay, and decrease in width, that is W original, okay, or W final minus W original, I am so sorry, L final divided by L final minus L original. I will rewrite, don't worry. What happened to this MCQ? MCQ learner, what happened? MCQ, what happened? Okay. So, yes. So that will be L final minus L original upon L original is 0.30, and reduction in the width, that is W final minus W original divided by W original, is going to be minus 0.16. Okay, if I write here, I will get the ratios, that is I will get from here L final divided by L original, I will get here, and from here I will get W final divided by W original. Tell me these values. So today I know the students from where they are coming and disturbing our class. Definitely we are going to see them. L final divided by L original is how much? Just here L final, that is L final divided by L original, it is going to be 1 plus, that is 1 plus 3.30, it is going to be 1.3. And here it is going to be 1 minus 0.16, it is going to be 0.84. Just put this value in the equation for the R, that is normal anisotropy of the sheet material. R is going to be ln of this WO divided by W final, that is width, original width divided by final width divided by ln of this W final divided by W original into L final divided by L original. Put the values and tell me the answer. So it is ln of WO original divided by W final. It is going to be 1 upon 0.84 divided by ln of this WF divided by WO, it is 0.84 only, multiply by this L final divided by L original, you have calculated as how much? 1.30. So this is your R. How much you are getting? R. Yes, yes, star 15. Very good, very good. So tell me the R, which is called it as the strain ratio, or it is a normal anisotropy of the sheet metal. So this is related to, dear students, the deep drawability or simply the limiting drawing ratio. Okay, in the originally it was given as simply the ratio of the strain in the width direction divided by strain in the thickness direction. Okay, as the failure of the curve is occurring because of the thinning, because of the huge longitudinal tensile stresses, based on that only we have obtained this particular equation. Otherwise, in the simple form, you can write this R as epsilon W divided by epsilon T, which is going to be ln of, say, W original divided by W final divided by ln of what? This is T original divided by T final. Okay, so 1.981, yes, that is the correct answer. Here, this answer is 1.976 I am getting. 1.976, this is the answer I am getting. Okay, are you getting this much? Very good. 1.98, it's fine, it's fine. 1.98, it's fine. 1.98, it's fine. Okay, this is the value of R. Okay, please, please go through it. Very nice, very nice. Next, which of the following statement representing a pair of main disadvantage of the ultrasonic machining? Main disadvantage, which is the true statement out of this ABCD? All abrasives are extremely expensive. It is not compulsory in the, if you take the abrasive slurry of the diamond, okay, then it is going to be the very expensive. All the abrasives are not expensive basically. Please understand, this is the very first statement. You just put the logic there. We are having silicon carbide, aluminium oxide, boron carbide, okay, and diamond. But this, see, these are having the cost, like diamond, B4C. We are knowing that which abrasive is capable to cut what, okay, and what is at the efficiency of using that particular abrasive. Okay, so all abrasives are expensive, extremely expensive. So that is not the correct state. No doubt tool wear is higher, definitely. Tool wear is definitely higher because the tool, actually the tip is also in this particular abrasive slurry. So there is a huge amount of tool wear rate in the case of USM, in the case of abrasive jet machining. Yes, so definitely A is not correct. Okay, or this cannot be the complete disadvantage. Material removal rate is low. Yes, dear. Material removal rate is low in the USM machining, in the abrasive jet machining. Yes, and tool rate is high. Yes, definitely, dear students. So this B statement, somewhat good thing they are saying. Yes, both the things are very correct. That is, this is the limitation or disadvantage of the ultrasonic machine. Yes, material removal rate is very less, or the tool wear is high. Okay, that is absolutely correct, dear students. So next statement C, just look at the statement C. Material removal rate is low and process fails in case of elect. अरे भैया यहाँ पे conductivity का सवाल ही क्या है? Basically we try to get the material application, like highly brittle material or hard or brittle material we are generally able to machine. If I talk about the hardness of the workpiece material should be more than the 45 HRC, then you can just very nicely use this particular USM process. But it is not requirement that the material should be a highly electrical conductor. So it is not the basic disadvantage for this or limitation for the USM. So again, in this case also, they are saying extremely expensive. Definitely it is not C naught, then A naught, and D is also not the correct answer here. So B Bombay, dear students, is very very correct answer. Are you getting my point? Very easy, fantastic, dear students. Ishan, Sushil, TV, very good. Take the next question. B Bombay is the correct answer. Take the next question. Tell me this. Just stereolithography, fuse deposition, modeling. Okay. So this is based upon your additive manufacturing, dear students. Okay. So tell me. What is the correct answer? So what is the correct answer, dear students? So I will just write here the process. Just if any match the pair kind of thing is there, I will write here the supply phase, and here the layer creation technique if I have. Okay, so if I take the very first process, that is the stereolithography. Okay, so here the supply phase is liquid. If I take the fuse deposition modeling, there will be again the liquid, supply phase is liquid. If I take here the ballistic particle manufacturing, there will be again liquid. Only the 3D printing, okay, we are having the supply phase in the powder form. Okay, so here the stereolithography, of course, there is a how the layer by layer we are creating the layer by layer by the liquid layer curing. Liquid layer curing. Okay, then in this particular fuse deposition modeling, we are using this extrusion of this melted polymer by extrusion of the melted polymer. By this ballistic particle manufacturing, we are having the droplet deposition. And 3D printing, of course, it is a binder droplet deposition into the powder layer. Okay, so these are the techniques for the layer creation. So if you just match it very nicely, so the D Daly, just go through it, D Daly will be the correct answer. It is kind of theoretical part, just go through that in the adaptive manufacturing. It is newly added topic since last year. Okay, go through that. So the next question on your non-traditional machining, NTM, non-traditional machining process. Very very simple question. Come on, they are actually asking you the, see here, just see the unit of this MRR. If they are asking in the grams per second, definitely it will be the m dot. Okay, the m dot, yes or no? It is not actually the MRR in terms of meter or centimeter cube per second. It is, dear students, mass flow rate, m dot. Okay, that is in grams per second. You know what is the mass flow rate in the EDM process? I told you the formula, m dot is equal to AI divided by FC. They have given the comparison here for the iron and the cobalt. For the cobalt, they are asking the m dot. They have given the value of m dot for the iron. How much it is given for the iron? It is going to be 0.26 grams per second. All the related things like gram atomic weight for the iron, 56 gram is given, the valency of the iron, it is 2 given, current condition given, it is 1000 amperage, and efficiency of the current, dear student, it is given 85%, that is say 0.85. Same fashion, they have given the data for the cobalt also. Okay, that is valency is 2, gram atomic weight is 58, current passing is 2000 ampere, and the current efficiency is 90%. So let us write here the data for the cobalt. M dot for the cobalt, they are asking how much the gram atomic weight for the cobalt, it is how much, 58. Then the valency for the cobalt, it is 2. Current efficiency for the cobalt is 90%, that is a 0.90. Okay, so you just take the ratio, dear students. You know the ratio. If I take say M dot for the cobalt divided by M dot for the iron, it is going to be ए आई डिवाइडेड बाय एफ जेड फॉर द कोबाल्ट मल्टीप्लाई बाय एफ जेड डिवाइडेड बाय ए आई फॉर द आयरन. सो वैलेंसी ऑल्सो सेम जेड जेड इट इज गोइंग टू गेट कैंसल आउट. फैराडेज कॉन्स्टेंट इट इज गोइंग टू बी कॉन्स्टेंट इन ऑल द केसेस ऑफकोर्स. सो इट विल बी this gram atomic weight into the current condition. Of course I have to multiply the efficiency for the current for this cobalt divided by ai into efficiency for this iron. So m dot for the cobalt divided by for the iron it is how much 0.26 gram per second is equal to gram atomic weight for this cobalt 58, current is how much 2000, efficiency is 0.90 divided by for the iron gram atomic weight is 56, current is 1000 multiplied by it is efficiency is 0.85. Tell me what is m dot for the cobalt. Tell me the answer in grams per second. All the things are given very nicely. Just write here the gram, that is material removal, okay, in grams per second. Mass flow rate. How much it is? See the question very nicely. All the things I have enlisted here for the cobalt and iron. Okay, just take the ratio, you will get the values. Faraday's value 96500, it is going to be constant, it is get cancelled out. Valency for the iron and cobalt, it is 2, it is given. Okay, very nice, you just write the things and get the value for m dot in case of cobalt. How much it is? I am getting 0.2. Chalo, I want to see the answer in the chat box. How much it is? Yes, 0.57. That is absolutely correct. Yes, correct answer. 0.57 is absolutely correct. Very good, Shubham. Very, very good. Fantastic. Okay. So this is how, dear students, yes, we have solved quite 11 number of questions here. I hope you get good revision. Okay, even though you are preparing with some other subject, definitely it is going to be the quite good revision when you are solving some questions like this, right? Isn't it? So after, say, day after tomorrow on 29th of December, I am coming live again with the complete production engineering. Okay, not only the material science, not only the casting or welding. Yes, this is already planned in the month of January. You are going to get that. Okay, these marathons. Okay, so don't worry about it. So 29th of December, meet me at 5 PM on our Hindi YouTube channel. Okay, where we are having the series Ladai Jeet Ki. Okay, that we are going to have their session for the production engineering, complete production engineering. Okay, some good questions we are going to solve so that you can get a very good revision there. Okay, and just that's it from my side. Any issues, any queries, any doubts, definitely you can ask me. Yes, how is your preparations? Not only about the production, but overall GATE 2022. I hope you are doing well. You are actually moving with the pace. Okay, in your in the whatever leftover part in the preparations, or if it is done in the revision, you are doing your well. So thank you so much. Definitely, we are coming with again such a good questions only, new questions only. Day after tomorrow, meet me there. Till then, bye bye. Thank you so much. No option on the app. Manoj Wadile. Sir, I want to buy Baju's test, but there is no option on the app. So basically nowadays in the course itself, dear students, we are providing the test series. So no any other as far as my knowledge is based, but I will just have the inquiry regarding to this query. Okay, and if you are there on the Telegram channel, do follow me on the Telegram channel so that I can put the answer for your query. Okay, Manoj, so join me there in the Telegram so that I can put there the answer for this your query. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care. And Jai Hind, Jai Hind. We will stop. Thank you so much.